I met this class, the class of 1988, 4 years ago in August 1984. Another class of many with which I've been associated for almost 30 years. A few weeks ago, I was in a reflective mood in my office and mentioned to Jenny Goodman, a senior student, that I felt this group of students had a certain uniqueness, cohesiveness, a depth that I had rarely experienced. Jenny said that her sixth grade teacher had made the same observation when they were sixth graders at Dover School. I contacted Diane Smith, that Dover teacher, and shared my feelings. She remembered this group well, mentioning many students by name, and she recalled that this was a very special class. She related that, quote, they were bright, cohesive, caring, worked together, and were always willing to help one another. They wanted to excel, they were good leaders, and generally just a dream to teach, unquote. I am sure the same report would come from Blue Hills, Meyerholtz, and Muir. You are a special group, and thanks for being who you are. And thanks to the parents and families for providing love and guidance through the years. In closing, I would like to share a writing by an anonymous author entitled, Who is Educated? A professor in Chicago is reported to have given the following test to his pupils. He told them they were not really educated unless they could say yes to the following questions. Has your education given you sympathy with all good causes and made you support them? Has it made you public-spirited? Has it made you a brother to the weak? Have you learned how to make friends and to keep them? Do you know what it is to be a friend to yourself? Can you look an honest man or woman straight in the eye? Do you see anything to love in a little child? Will a lonely dog follow you down the street? Can you be high-minded and happy in the meaner drudgeries of life? Do you think washing dishes and working in the garden just as compatible with high thinking as piano playing or playing golf? Are you good for anything to yourself? Can you be happy alone? Can you look out on the world and see anything but dollars and cents? Can you look into a mud puddle by the wayside and see anything in the puddle but mud? Can you look into the sky at night and see beyond the stars? And most important, can your soul claim a relationship with God? Thank you.